find that those who are elderly, those who cannot contribute to society anymore, those people who are physically, mentally challenged, these people, in our eyes, do not deserve to exist because they are of no use. They cannot produce, they cannot contribute, they take up space, they take up our time. My dear brothers and sisters, this is not what the Lord is telling us in today's gospel. In today's gospel, the story of the adulterous woman, what did Jesus do? Jesus forgave that woman. Jesus did not make a sin out of adultery. He didn't say anything. He didn't even scold her. He didn't even reprimand her. He simply asked her, is there anyone who has no sin? He told the people, then you can throw the first stone. And no one did. And so the Lord Jesus, a man of great compassion, a man who understands the weaknesses of humanity, he knows who we are. That is why Pope Francis is also encouraging us. Today we know that one of the greatest challenges in our times is really the family, marriages. We know the difficulties of strengthening our marriage and really building a loving family. That is why Pope Francis says we must be tolerant. We must be forgiving. What society needs today, really, a society that is gracious, compassionate, forgiving, and tolerant. If we Christians cannot build this kind of society, it means to say we don't understand the essence of the gospel, which is that of mercy and love. We can say many things, but all would be in vain when people do not see us as people who forgive, people who feel with the pains, the weaknesses, the sufferings of the rest of humanity. And so, you know, my dear brothers and sisters, even as we proclaim mercy, many people misunderstood Pope Francis, thinking that mercy therefore means that you can continue to sin. We do not condone the sin. We are compassionate to the sinner. That's why Jesus told the woman, sin no more. Because when we continue the selfish, evil way of life, not only we destroy ourselves, we destroy our loved ones, we destroy unity, we destroy peace in family, in society. But the primacy remains mercy. Why is that so? Why is mercy more important? Comes before repentance. Until we receive the mercy and the forgiveness of God, my dear brothers and sisters, we cannot be merciful towards others. You notice in today's gospel, those men who were accusing the adulterous woman, what was the real reason? They were not conscious of their own lustfulness. They were not conscious that they themselves have committed sins, their own feelings. You know, when we think that we are perfect, when we think that we are sinless, when we are not conscious of our own inadequacy and sinfulness, then we begin to condemn others. That's why St. Paul, in the second reading, he did say, I'm still striving for perfection, still a long way off. And this is true for all of us. So my dear brothers and sisters, today, on this fifth Sunday of Lent, which is actually, in the olden days, it's called Passion Week, we are called to contemplate on the Passion of Christ so that we can understand the mercy of God, His forgiveness for all that we have done, and His love. And St. Paul says in the second reading, also contemplate on His resurrection, because the resurrection means there is hope, that love is greater than hatred, and that life will overcome death.